At every point of our fluid, we have a velocity, but also we have pressure. Velocity has a direction, pressure doesn't. Now let's try to find out how to incorporate pressure in our equations. To make things simple, we look at a one-dimensional situation, a straight pipe filled with fluid. Capital A is the cross-section area of that pipe. Let's replace some amount of that fluid with a piston of width delta x. And let's assume that the pressure to the left of that piston is P1 and the pressure to the right of that piston is P2. Then this force is proportional to the difference of those two pressures. And if P1, the pressure on the left, is larger than P2, the pressure on the right, the force is to the right. So we have to choose signs like that. And the proportionality constant is simply the area. If you double the area, you double the force. If we say that this piston has a volume of V, then the area, of course, is the volume of the piston divided by its width. So if we want to use this as part of our differential equations, what should we be writing? What's the force per volume? The partial derivative of pressure with respect to x minus the partial derivative of the pressure with respect to x, half the partial derivative, or the pressure divided by the square root of the area.